How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I want to be talking about three of my favorite website builders in today's industry. Okay, and that will be Squarespace, Bluehost, WordPress Builder, and finally Wix. Now, before we begin, if you guys are interested in any of the website builders mentioned today, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below. Now, starting with my personal favorite, and that'll be Squarespace. And Squarespace is definitely going to be the one that I recommend to, well, 90% of people. Honestly, it is easily one of the best visually pleasing website builders out there. It is very easy to use, and it's just great for visual assets like photos, illustrations, and graphic designs, as well as just e-commerce generally, podcasts. If you're a doctor, you're a yoga teacher, you're trying to set up schedules. There are so many benefits and to using Squarespace, and it just makes everything incredibly easy. The Squarespace website builder is very intuitive, and you can just log in, get started, and you have some of the best templates in the market today, honestly. I would easily choose Squarespace's templates over any other template. The backend editor is also something else. So, you know, once you're into the website, just you can preview, you can get all kinds of previews here from tablet, mobile, and desktop previews. And once you're good with one of these websites, you can just start and you are good to go. Again, the backend editor is incredibly intuitive. It's great for beginners like the newly graduated graphic designer looking to build a portfolio, or the photographer who just wants to make their first business website. They're also great for new generations of creators and influencers, especially for YouTubers and TikTok influencers, just to help them create a home for the brand outside of those platforms. Squarespace plays especially well with YouTube, allowing you to embed videos along with more information or content that exists solely on your website. And editing your website, obviously here you have a template, and you are able to create new pages for these templates and whatnot. And here, as you can tell, when it comes to, let's say, just changing the order, all you have to do is just drag and drop, and everything will happen in real time. You want to put your about in the beginning again. It's very easy to do that. Let's say you want your contact to be in the beginning or the first option, just to make your contact as accessible as possible. Again, these website templates are super easy to use, and it's very easy to make one of these templates yours. Just click edit, and you are able to edit the sections, edit the blocks individually. You can, kind of customize them to make them your own as well. Obviously, there are other videos that I have out there to teach you a little bit more about the Squarespace editor specifically. So be sure to check it in the description down below. I'll throw it in the description if you're interested in learning more about the editor. I don't want to make this video too long. I'm just going to be talking about some of the best aspects of each website builder today. And with Squarespace, you're going to be getting the best templates, giving you the best looking websites out of the three website builders mentioned today. And this is super easy to use if you're just starting out, and even seasoned website managers might find it a breath of fresh air compared to the alternative. Sometimes, like in WordPress, you're editing your site in the back end, but then you have to go to the front end to see what it looked like when you're finished. But with Squarespace, as you're building the blog post, you're seeing the changes happen all in real time. And I think that's really useful. That's one aspect that makes it very easy to use. Now, the cons of Squarespace's website builder: while Squarespace ranked fairly high on customization, it was still an area of some contention for some users. Now, some users do enjoy what Squarespace offers in terms of customization options and extra tools, such as the e-commerce function, integrated email marketing, and podcast support. However, it's still fairly limited when it comes to the enormous customizability of WordPress, and that'll be our next website builder here with Bluehost. Not to mention that you might have to pay more for the plugins and widgets that you might need to make certain things work. And while the website builder is easy to use, it could certainly be more intuitive. But generally speaking, honestly, it's not exactly a point of contention for me. Squarespace's support is very helpful and they're fairly responsive. And of course, you have plenty of guides that will help you over with creating your website without having to go through too much trouble. So overall, Squarespace is a great website builder, having ranked well across all areas. You'll be able to create good looking blogs or portfolios, but if you're looking to scale up your website for tons of traffic, you'd probably be better off with the next option here. With Bluehost, and yes, I am talking about the WordPress website builder. And the WordPress website builder is very customizable. It's also very scalable. This is a content management system that can grow as large as you want or be scaled back to as small as you want. The scalability and customizability is about as good as it gets, really. Now, the learning curve can be a little bit steep, admittedly, but if you put in the time and invest, you will get a lot of return. And since WordPress is a staple generally in website building, you can just Google anything about WordPress and you will find a solution for it. So you are able to find your solutions and you won't necessarily be stuck. Now, the customer support for WordPress.org is not exactly the best, but again, you are able to find your solutions online with a little bit of research. Now, WordPress also has more than 11,000 themes. Many of them are free and some are paid. Now, my recommendation is to go for a paid one if you can afford it. The benefit of doing this is that your website will easily stand out from the rest and you'll get more options with customization. When you go with one of the more popular free themes, it's just going to look like hundreds of other website WordPress websites. However, if you put in a little work and a little money, you'll end up with a site that's uniquely yours. And if you're a little hesitant about paying, WordPress scored well for ability to make money. And that's because WordPress allows users to easily integrate e-commerce functions, as well as powerful SEO tools such as Yoast to help capture organic traffic. Now, it's worth noting that there is a little bit of a learning curve with WordPress. The backend dashboard can frankly be a little overwhelming. The good news is that after just a little bit of exploring and experimenting, you'll get the hang of it in no time. If you just spend a little bit more time on the dashboard, you should be able to get the hang of it very easily. And if you do run into trouble, there's just a lot of information about building up your website using WordPress, so you shouldn't be too intimidated by it. And like I said before, WordPress is scalable. If you want to build a big website with a ton of different assets, you can choose the right plugins to help. You can hire a developer or yourself if you have the website building skills to jump in the back end and build exactly what you need, especially if you know how to code. Now, if you want a website with WordPress, they give you two options. You can either build it for free or host it somewhere else. If you build it for free, this means your website will be hosted by WordPress. I don't recommend this for a number of reasons, and one of the obvious reasons is that you'll have to have a WordPress branded subdomain. So your website is going to look like, let's say, your website's name, .wordpress.com. And yeah, this is, I just really don't really recommend. And if you host it somewhere else, you'll get access to more resources and potentially a free unbranded domain name. This is where WordPress.org comes into play. I personally recommend Bluehost because Bluehost is definitely one of the best and most beginner-friendly website hosts in the business. And you will get a free domain with Bluehost. So yeah, no worries there if you're worried about having a weird looking domain. Bluehost offers rock bottom promotional pricing starting at just $275 per month. And be sure to check the description down below if you're interested. And every Bluehost plan comes with 24/7 live chat support, making their live chat support very accessible to everybody. Bluehost will also help you migrate to their host if you're coming from a different hosting service. Now, some of the cons of the WordPress website builder is that the dashboard can seem a little bit intimidating at first. Once you learn it, though, you'll be able to jump into the back end of any any WordPress website and know how to get around with ease. This can be a valuable skill to have and one that employers frequently look for. Still, this isn't going to be the website builder for you if you're looking to easily create a website out of the box with little to no site building experience or knowledge needed. But if you're willing to put in the work, learning even just the basics of WordPress can result in a massive return on investment. Not only will you be able to create a fully customized website, but you'll have a valuable skill, and you're definitely going to be using it if you continue on the right track with learning WordPress. But if that's not what you're looking for, then again, I would recommend Squarespace, which makes things much, much easier than WordPress. Now, the next website builder is going to be Wix. And Wix is going to be a great option if you're a beginner looking to build your first website. It offers a way that makes your website building experience as painless as possible. And their AI just helps you create websites by simply asking you a bunch of questions. And I have gone through the questions, some of the questions already. You'll end up having this dashboard right here, which if you just keep going through the questions, you'll be able to get there. And the AI, again, makes things just super easy. Wix is very intuitive and they give you great tools to create great websites. They have templates for music, art, fashion, health, travel, photography, construction, and restaurant sites. And if you need a little bit more hands-on help, they offer 24/7 callback service for US-based users, so an actual person can walk you through any issue. That is a rarity in the website builder world, and definitely something that'll help you in the long run. That way, if something breaks or your website crashes, you can immediately call someone up to help you. I have tested it out myself, so I jumped in and created my own website from scratch, and my experience was very pleasant overall. So I've been given these options because I picked e-commerce. I said I have a store I needed to run. I called it New York Corner Shop. And these are some of the options that they're giving me. You can just skip or use one of these designs. Let's just say I'll use this design right here. And all of these questions actually will help you tailor your pages for you just based on a bunch of questions that you're asked by Wix. And as you can tell here, the editing is very easy. You're able to just, let's say, add this page, add that page. Let's just go with this and that. And let's just go to the editing. Overall, with Wix, it's just incredibly easy to edit and manage and do everything. Now, you could get your hands dirty and choose a template and build your website from the ground up, or you could simply answer a few questions about the type of website that you want, and Wix's AI builder will handle all the work for you. And you will be able to have a decent looking website in no time. And as you can tell, it's pretty easy to just navigate. Let's say, you know, you want to manage something here, you want to edit, click edit, and you are good to go. Overall, I can really compare this to Squarespace. Which one is easier to use? I myself prefer Squarespace, and that's because I don't really enjoy having the AI create things for me. I would rather just create things myself, because that will result in an overall much more unique website, something that represents my vision, rather than just having the AI create something for me. Now, if that's what you're looking for, that's completely fine. And if that's not what you're looking for, you can also get your hands dirty with Wix. But for me personally, I would rather do the customization myself instead of having the AI do it for me. But if that's your thing and you want to really just not put in any kind of work and just switch up some text and some pictures, then you are good to go with Wix. Though take note that all of Wix's plans are automatically set to auto renew. Just keep that in mind if you're just trying to, let's say, try out Wix for a year. Be sure to cancel it before that year runs out. Otherwise, you're going to get, this can be a big deal for a lot of people, especially for scrappy startups trying to make and save as much money as possible. And if you want to recoup some of the expenses with an e-commerce site, you'll have to pay for a more expensive plan for the subscription fee. And this is when I would just recommend Squarespace, since you don't really have to pay any extra money to get your e-commerce site going. So overall, for me, I would recommend Squarespace for most of you guys. If you're looking for something with more customization, you can go with the WordPress, especially with Bluehost. Bluehost giving you a whole lot of benefits, including security and performance benefits, especially if you are a beginner. And Bluehost cPanel is super easy to use as well. And if you're looking for, well, you know, an AI kind of generated sort of website, then Wix will definitely be a great choice, especially if you want something that works right out of the box with little to no customization needed. So that'll be it for this video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this or learned something new. And if you'd like to get yourself any of these website builders, be sure to check the links in the description down below. I'll be sure to find the best discounts. I will try to find a discount for Wix, although I have not been able to procure one. So you might just have to go with the offer that they have on their website. But if you are interested in Bluehost or Squarespace, then be sure to check the links in the description down below. I was able to indeed get you guys some discounts so that you can make use of them. And overall, if you are looking for something super easy to use, I personally would recommend Squarespace over Wix, but that's just my personal preference. So that'll be it for this video. Comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything related to web hosting and website building. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.